was my birthday today, and the first thing I thought was, one, happy to open up my eyes. I feel so awesome. I'm grateful. All the goods, all the good vibes. It's a pretty Hall & Oates morning, to be honest. And then I reflected on previous birthdays, and it wasn't so long ago that I just dreaded my birthday. I approached it with resistance because to me it symbolized, this is so dark, another year closer to my death. And that was also because I just wasn't happy. It also symbolized another year that you struggled, another year that you felt crap, and you're getting older, you're missing out on life. Yeah, they were dark times. And it's the complete opposite now. I mean, I have so much to be grateful for. I've got a beautiful wife, a beautiful family, two amazing and healthy kids. I've got an incredible family around me, my mom, my dad, my brother, my sister-in-law. And musically, like I'm expressing myself in a way that feels true to me, from that deeper place. I love how the gigs are going. I love that I'm actually gigging. You know, it wasn't that long ago where I couldn't even get up on stage. So the fact that I'm up in the air now, flying around, gigging, I've got a killer management team around me that supports me both mentally, like emotionally, and from a business point of view as well. What else? I love where I live. I love my day job. Still, after 10 years, I still enjoy going to work and getting creative, and writing for the screen. I love the people that I work with. There's so much to be grateful for. Physically and mentally, I couldn't feel any more resilient. And I feel like the energy that I have is real now. It's not an adrenaline-based energy. It's not, and the confidence that I have doesn't come from a place of naivety, like that youthful confidence that you have. It's more because you haven't really fallen flat on your face, but I have. I've face planted like a motherfucker, and I got back up and I've learned from it. So but also the joy that I feel is not hinged on those things as well, because when I was at my darkest, on paper you'd think that I should be the happiest person alive. I mean, I remember sitting on Coogee Beach, which is where I was living at the time, going, I have a 2-bedroom apartment that I have a beautiful wife, I mean, fiance at the time, the best family that anybody could ask for. I have a day job that focuses on my creative skills, that pays me well, good people around me, and I couldn't be any more unhappy and depressed. And that was kind of a scary moment, because I realized that I couldn't buy, no goal in a material sense was ever going to make me happy, because I had achieved what I wanted to achieve. So that made me feel lost, because I'm like, wow, if I'm unhappy, how do I fix this? So, wow. Yeah. Anyway, thought I'd share that. I also don't know where the years went. That's a bit weird. To wake up and go, I'm 37. That's weird. I mean, I was always the young one. That's weird. feel good.